Alrighty, might as well get started. See, I've left myself in another fine mess once again. I have one hit point, and I'm not even sure where I am. But there are people screaming. No clue. Let me try and.
I'll see what's ahead.
I'll have this open in no time. As promised.
Maximum quantity of camping supplies, so I just camp out here. In this really cool place that I would love to sleep myself. Boop. Awesome. Wait. Oh yeah, construction's gonna be fun. But this will take time. Let's read this first. For the last 2 years, sailors on the Grace of Kamena have seen a pair of lights dancing over the waves late at night. Those who have come close to have reported hearing two women's voices singing a song of unparalleled beauty. Some believe that they are the souls of Alessa and Polani, ill-fated lovers from a century ago who were cast out of Ansenzi by a mob driven from the cliffs and driven from the cliffs to their death. Fun. Ansenzi's Duchess? I guess. Duquesse. Condemned the mob's actions, but the unsympathetic Sangreta Ducala did a little to punish the offenders. Since the rumors about the lights have spread, romantic Valians have gone to the cliffs or even rowed small boats out from the shore at night to catch a glimpse of the spirits. And Chenzi's new duke is doing his best to curb the behavior. But he believes the only true remedy will be putting the spirits to rest. No small task, given when and where they appear. I'd really love to get this to Palutena, but, ghost hunting. Yeah, let's just let the devil do it. Okay. Back to full health. Where am I? What am I doing? Oh, I think I'm in the DLC dungeon. Okay, this is fine. This is good. Nice.
Nice and quiet.
Something good, you can have half.
Okay, here we go. Oh, this.
The guardians will hold the door as long as need be.
Everyone else is ready. So few of us remain.
Lord Abidun, guide our hands and steel our hearts. Give us the mercy of your forge.
Something seems bad about that crystal. Eye sockets of the skull itself are golden rings, evidently meant to house some manner of gem or instrument. This seems like a fine thing to do. Yeah, I think I fucked that up and probably should have saved.
What stirs in the heart of the battery?
I didn't fuck it up? I don't know. So, there's two ways out. Let me try this one first. Oh boy. So yeah, I haven't played this in a while, obviously. It's been months. And I think it was months the last time too. Hello, Seawolf. How's it going? I'm just talking about how I don't remember anything. But I feel like we're getting close on this DLC stuff. Oh. Well, that doesn't seem very close
you
at all.
You all sure have a lot of traditions. Okay. In Masuk, it's our connection to our past that keeps us going. I'll say it's kept you going for 5 years. And yours has kept you running for 30. I'm gonna look at this thing over here.
So, I guess there's gonna be some other way of getting across there? Excellent. That is good to hear.
I'll see what I can find.
There we go. Oh, no, I just need to do... Oh, I just need... I only had one. I thought I had two. Well, have I... Okay, I can't believe I thought that you could just go into the forge.
At least it's warm in here.
So I need to find another Audra Stone? That wasn't gonna be my plan. This is... Okay, well... I assume I've... Well, there's something already. Yep. I'm just gonna... I got less than 8 hours. No, I'm not going to try and finish this game. I believe there's still quite a... Well, I guess I only really need to finish the DLC. I can finish the main game off stream. Or should I not? I don't know. I've already finished the main game, and it's not that exciting, but I suppose in order to bring it to a close, I should. Right, end of White March 1. Okay. Good lord, where the hell could Audra Stones be then? I know where I can find out information. I need to figure out how to use it. Okay. Yep, they're not convinced. Nope. Oh boy. I have honestly no idea, so I'm just gonna go outside to get my bearings a little bit. And also because maybe the answer is... maybe the answer is just right here. It's like, how do I get into that other tower? Oh, well that was...
I'll see what I can find.
Let's just walk around in here for a second. Okay. Yeah. That's good. And I do like belts. Okay, none of that was what I needed, though. I guess I'm looking for an Audra Stone because I have to put something in the other eye. And I put one Audra Stone in one eye. Oh, I seem to be quite far down. Have I gone all the way this way? So much screaming. Yes. I really hope that it's like in this dungeon and it's not in a completely different place. This seems likely. They're both on this map? Okay. Well, it's nice to know. There's a skeleton, goddammit. Diamond. And a sigil. It's for some quest. Wow. Apparently I was very sloppy. When I was going through here, I believe I was charging towards the end. Somehow I got that skull. There's a trap, anyway. Oh. Yes, I just didn't do. Is this a puzzle? Getting a little close. Oh, I can't. Are there more sigils? Are there three goddamn skeletons? Apparently there are. Wow, there are three things on this map and I only had one? That's pretty impressive. Let's me play these games. Hello, skeleton friends. Did I, like, put the sigils perhaps in my thing? Can you do that? All my pets just sitting in here. No, because I probably put the sigil into my thing. Yeah. Wait, the sigils just disable the traps? But it was a quest item. And that seems important somehow. And also, it's more tangible than an Audra stone. Which I don't even know where I pulled that out of. I love it when the audio fucks up. Oh, hello. Apparently I didn't come this way at all. Young Ice Beetle is my favorite rapper. Is there a Young Ice Beetle? Yeah, Young Ice Beetle. That's fantastic. I'm quiet. Maybe that's for the best, to be honest. Have you met me? Wow, that Young Ice Beetle survived the longest.
I'll go on ahead.
Please be on their corpses. Yeah, maybe I'm gonna go back.
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
Yep. Thank you. Let's look for clues. No clues. Ooh, damn it. God fucking damn it. That is the worst. Ah, jeez. Well, that's something. Please don't be... Eh? At least it's not camping supplies. Wait, there's this whole other room I haven't been in. What am I talking about? Very silly. Still nothing.
Strengthen us with your flame, Lord Abidun.
Yes, strengthen me with your flame, Daddy. Sorry. God.
Temper us for the crucible.
Oh, were you talking? Sorry. Where was that book? I think I remember what it looked like. It's kind of hard to concentrate with everyone screaming all the time. This is it? Are we gonna bind some souls? This seems like a great idea. Abidun. Yep, just can't see past the word pervert because I'm an idiot with a trash brain. Like a babe is heated steel, fragile and easily corrupted. Handle it gently, lest your haste twist and warp it. Okay, so this seems... Okay. Don't pervert the babe. You guys want to come back and talk some more? No? Okay. Guess we'll just do this thing. Let's not twist our steel here, people. Let's... There we go. You hear another rending shriek! But not of machinery. Around you rises a chorus of howls, bodiless voices raised in rage and despair. Oh, man! Yeah, if there was a multiple choice quiz, that's like the ultimate. Oh boy, this is not good. I guess I probably should have seen this coming. Okay, well, I guess this isn't terrible positioning. Yeah, just stay on sword duty. Boy. Okay, so now things have gotten a little... let's focus on that guy. And we should also maybe cast a spell. Yeah, that seems like a good idea. Just keep doing what you're doing. Let's just... this is not good. Still no wounds. What is the barb doing? Wait, where's Palutena? This is impossible to see. Where's Palad... No. Maneha's... Oh, just right there. Okay. Jesus Christ. Yes. It's good enough. Well, that's good. Just do a flip kick on that guy. Yes! Amazing. I love monks. I just love monks so much. I play a monk in Diablo 3 now, and it's very good and fun. Still don't need that. This is just let this fight do. Oh, but let's definitely do something with this. Maybe this didn't go as planned. Yeah, start screaming again. You recruited a perpetually drunk pirate who is classed as a monk, which I found pretty funny. That is extremely funny. And is that a playable character, or is it just like a companion, or like one of those side? Oh, geez, that's bad. But that character sounds very good. Yeah, let's get you out of here. No, wait. Yeah, a killing bolt sounds good. And then you do this. Okay, excellent. You stay on that, you stay on that. Excellent. We got some wounds going now. So this fight is over. Okay. Interesting. Whoa, achievement. Just stick it all in my gob. So we done here? Or I guess we should touch it. Nothing seems different. Okay. Guess we'll just peace out? I still don't understand what in the hell is going on at all. Maybe go this way? Gosh, I want to play Deadfire. I just really want to play that game. But not till I finish my DLC vegetables. Well, I tried touching it. Nothing seems different out here. Cool, cool, cool. Something else I need to touch. Well, I do need to touch that for sure. And that. Nothing else to touch, though. Did get an achievement. Something else? I did click the pillar. Oh, I need to talk to it, not examine it.
Stop, Marauder! Our bodies are dust already. Must you profane holy ground with further violence? Did the height of our walls offend you? Did we cross your borders? Sail you weak steel?
Is this DLC commentary?
Tell us, why did you invade our fortress?
Not enough lore.
No, that cannot be. Abaddon wouldn't allow it.
I wouldn't trust a guy named Abaddon.
Wake up, Exandru! This is why Abaddon gave us the White Forge, that we might take up arms and deal with villains like this.
Such a magnificent device, and she can only see it as a tool for war. She shames our grandparents, who wandered this continent and... Quiet, both of you! Can't you feel it?
Can't you
feel it?
Yes. Silence. But you...
That was good.
You entered our keep and found it abandoned.
That was a good moment.
What happened to us?
Oh, I am smart, but not lore savvy. So that sounds about right. The official history is that you destroyed yourselves, but it looks like someone or something invaded the battery!
I've never seen anything like them. Twice the size of any ogre, and positively fearless. They were...
Eyeless.
Eyeless.
Yet no matter how hard we fought, or how deep we hid, they kept coming for us.
Some kind of magfolk. But bigger than
mag
me,
folk?
We knew of. We who survived never got close.
Is that
close.
A slur?
They were relentless. Unnaturally so. We should have taken our steel and pushed east.
What's to say they didn't come from the east? From the lands Maroon so coveted? It was a punishment for taking this gift of Abaddon, the White Forge, and squandering it on our greed and vanity.
Feel their doubt and dissent in the stifling heat of the forge.
We retreated until there was no place left to go, until those of us who remained were here.
Here, with the salvation Abaddon had left us.
Use the White Forge to channel your souls into the battle.
Yes. Using the same methods with which we had fashioned so much cold steel.
Seems like a real bad idea, bro.
It was agony. Feeling your soul ripped from your flesh. Feeling every part of you torn asunder.
Yup.
But it saved us.
Imprisoned us.
It was Abaddon's grace. Now, we inhabit the monument our people built to the White Forge. The White Forge belongs to Abaddon, of course. It is here that he built his own body. And whether he found this place or created it, it's a truly remarkable smithy.
Yeah, it's pretty cool looking. I mean, the skull motif.
But it was Abaddon's call that led our forefathers here after generations spent along the Pearl Coast and Air Glomfoth.
So the old stories say. Then again, I can't see any other reason our grandfathers would have stayed here when greener lands lay east.
Yum. How does it work, though?
Its fires have been blessed by Abidun. They're fed by Aeora's molten heartbeat and veined with Audra that runs to the center of the world.
Which explains their conductive power. See, these Audra veins allowed us to siphon essence into steel as we shaped it.
And that essence, the extraordinary heat of the forge, and our smith's skill is what made Durgan's steel so remarkable.
And now you're here.
Stuck here, you mean. With all the others who sought to escape the Eyeless.
Wow, something from, like, the original character creation. They stuck it in here. I don't know if I've ever seen this. I will say this thing because I'm a drifter. Staying in one place like this would never suit me.
Had we thought longer on the fate that awaited us,
they don't even...
we might have chosen a quick death to this slow agony.
Blasphemy! There's no greater honor than remaining here, watching over the White Forge.
I'm not a clergyman. So these two options they can't do. That's weird that they're both that, but...
The long vigil is a quiet duty, but a noble one, nonetheless.
Dissident. Nice.
I only wish we could protect...
I felt like a monk should be a drifter. Like a kung fu monk?
Or do something. Anything. We were once among the greatest smiths in the known world. Tell me, do Kith still speak of us?
I mean, I believe this is true, although I can't really...
That is good to know. It's only a shame that this legacy is nothing but a memory.
Is this why you braved the restless souls of Durgan's battery? To recover the process of Durgan's steel?
I guess this is like this is very... This is good dialogue writing, because it's like role-playing options versus, potential lines that are funny. Yeah, exactly. If you're a kung fu monk and you're not found in your home, you must be a drifter. Yeah, 3 and 4. That's what I'm, like, trying to choose between.
Then I hope you're satisfied with what you found here.
Godlike.
At least you get to leave this place.
But it was good to be remembered, however briefly.
As the souls of Durgan's battery speak to you, their collective essence takes shape, much like Meerwald's did. There are scores of them, all torn by the conflicting purposes and trapped in the memory of their lost battle. Taste the bitterness of their uncertain existence and feel the persistent ache of centuries. It is a slow, agonizing fate, but you find it in your power to grant them another. I mean, I believe... Okay, yeah, so, I don't know if I talked about it on stream, but I basically have figured out how I want to end this in order to set up a Deadfire run, and that is to, I think... Well, I don't remember which gods I promised what to, but I promised something to all of the gods, so I'm going to have to make most of them unhappy, but I think I'm going to release the souls. So that would seem to tie in to this. You perceive the tenuous connections between the souls and the battery. As you sever them, the souls cry out, some in relief and others in rage. Pressure builds in the ether, which swarms with essence and energy. You cover your ears and grit your teeth against the devastating hum that builds in the core of your soul. Wow. The devastating hum that builds in the core of your soul. Tons of experience. Level up. Not even good enough for level up. Wait, what? New mechanic? Hell yeah! What did that do? Oh, okay. Is that it? Then I guess we'll just peace out. I got a refinder iron ingot. That will do something, I'm sure, someday. Oh, was that very important for crafting? I remember being upset at needing something. Excellent. Well, I mean, I guess I don't really need that to finish the main quest, which is really all I'm after now, because I care more about starting Deadfire than I do about finishing every single side quest. I guess I'd just figure out which ones affect Deadfire. Well, I hope there's something you can make with one. Okay. This seems like a place too. I definitely remember this. Battery gate, that seems like what I want. This is the only content that I haven't done twice, technically. Yeah. Yeah, I'm not worried about the main quest was very easy. I was underleveled for it anyway, and it was a challenging battle, and I enjoyed it because I knew that if I was going to be any higher level, it would have been a cakewalk.
By the time you stepped out of Durgan's battery and into the new snow outside, word had already spread of strange lights rising from the fortress and energy crackling in the sky. The survivors of Starward flocked to Durgan's battery, their steps hastened by the promise of peace and prosperity at last. They mended their walls, gathered their strength, and prepared their town for the new opportunities that were sure to come. And with the voices of Durgan's battery silent at last, none heard the distant groan of something stirring among the peaks, as massive and relentless as an avalanche.
Cool. Rest in any location outside the White March? Man.
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
Mm-hmm. Well, actually, let me see if there are any side quests we want to do. Abbey of the Fallen Moon? Where's that? It's probably in this map. Yep. Well, I'm not gonna do that one either. Video game development is really difficult, everyone. Okay, I guess I could try and go... Let's see, I was at the very bottom, wasn't I?
I must say, I'm impressed.
Better be. Yes, I did release the dragon. But there's still a boss battle, I remember, that I like. I did? Okay. Well, I guess I did. Let me look at my achievements. It must have been a memorable stream, I'm sure. God. Was it that long ago? Yeah, like complete the last 5 levels. And I believe, yeah. Okay, so I've done everything I can in the basement. everything else... Yeah, no, I'm good. That's hilarious. Yeah, so... What do I want? Let's do dexterity. No, wait. There's something better. Listen, no. No, intellect, yes. There we go. As you sleep, you are buoyed by buffeted by the vagaries of dreams. They tumble and thrash about you and fill your mind's eye with pale, glittering motes. They resolve into a light snowfall and a biting northerly wind. You recognize the mountains of the White March rising around you, and you shiver. You see Stalwart a few miles away, quiet and still, but for a few curling streams of smoke rising from the chimneys. Durgan's battery is perched above it, its shadow stretching into the valley. Not sure why it's telling me it is there. Above it all, you hear a deep, slow rhythm. That's fun. At first, it sounds like a distant drumming, but then it grows louder, cracking and through the dry air and booming from the mountain peaks. It builds until you feel it reverberating beneath your feet. I guess I'll just watch and listen. Each thud comes louder and faster than the next. Thunder echoes from the mountaintops as great sheets of ice and snow tumble down the slopes. But the rhythm keeps building, shattering frozen lakes like crystal saucers. New ravines split through the mountains as old chasms fill with snow and scree. A rock slide buries Stalwart, and Durgan's battery is shaken into rubble. That sucks. Shadows rise over the mountains, the vanguard of a massive army. You flee. You tumble from the foothills and bound across the deerwood, feeling the rumble of the advancing army all the while. I will barricade myself in my tent. Cadnua rises from the forest, its netted walls reaching out to you like a pair of strong arms. Your dreams are terrible. I hate them. You barricade yourself within the great hall as the pounding grows. Closer still. It rattles as the foundations of the Great Keep, and just as the masonry begins shaking loose, you hear an unholy battle cry coming from your courtyard. The ceiling collapses and sends a cascade of bricks and beams onto your head. You struggle to wakefulness, kicking at the bedding knotted around your legs. Wow, look at this image. Wow. As you shake free of the last bonds of sleep, you hear a voice whisper something in a language you've never heard, and you see an image of 100 shifting, staring eyes. Ah! You awaken feverishly warm and covered in sweat. Ugh. Gross. Gross, gross, gross. Waking covered in sweat is, like, an extremely unpleasant feeling. As I guess being covered in sweat generally is. Big sticky. The DLC seems good. I have high hopes for the second part.
I must say, I'm impressed.
Oh, you know what? I guess I are there things, like, does it matter if you do Adair's quest? Because I haven't done his side quest at all in this. For Deadfire. I suppose I haven't done Palutena's either. Or Alice. Wait, why haven't I done those? Have I done them? I definitely haven't done Adair's. Well, I guess I have done them. Cool. Okay. Yeah. I mean, I guess I don't really intend to use Adair much in Deadfire. Like, I really enjoyed him in my first playthrough, but I don't feel like he's essential to the story when there are so many other. High level? The rewards you receive will be the same regardless of the options you choose. Then I will steamroll it, sir. Thank you. Haha. If you want to talk to me about some increased rewards, then we can talk. But yeah, right. Okay. Well, as long as it's not like I can't recruit him at all. Ah, vicious mercenaries. Five days. I think we've got enough time. These are all built, yeah. Hireling payday. Anyone better? Nope. Yeah, I don't think you. No, that's good. Yeah. You know, maybe I will. Or at least for the first part of the game until
while
I have.
We wait, the enemy grows stronger.
I really
you
like someone.
Send more of us to die! Well, I'm not gonna stand around. Are you?
You've done plenty, Darien.
Yeah, Darien. You approach the source of the commotion and see a throng of villagers. They're arguing amongst themselves and hurling questions and demands at a lone figure perched above them. A young man stands on the spur of a rock, his clenched fists held aloft. Steam rises from his wild hair and flushed face as he shouts to the gathering.
Been a week since our people left these gates. A week since the Iron Flail took them.
What is the Iron Flail, Darien? He paces the outcropping, his eyes burning. You see a few scattered nods
yet
in the crowd.
We wait here behind our sturdy new walls, hiding in our rebuilt homes. We've done nothing.
Adair as a rogue sounds interesting. kind of a Magnus Burnsides. He brings his fist into his palm with a sharp smack. The crowd erupts, bristling with pointed fingers and pointed words. One woman steps forward, her eyes lock on the young man.
Who are you to tell us how to defend our own? You ain't been here 2 months!
Yeah, Darian! Several of the others grunt and hoot. I'm not going to do sound effects for that. I just made a choice. You feel a shift in the crowd, like a changing tide.
And since I got here, I've been working alongside the rest of you. Don't start with that again.
A handful of others nod along with him, but they cringe and flinch as another villager joins the fray, shaking his finger at the young orator.
Well, it was your idea to send our people to that damn fort in the first place. If it weren't for you and other leeches that come up with you, we wouldn't be in this mess.
I think my favorite thing in RPGs, and probably the reason I play them, is discovering new characters, new playable like party members, and deciding whether or not I like them. Like, that is like by far what keeps me coming back. It's like, ooh, there are all these cool character designs. I don't know how I feel about these people. I can't wait to see how their story unfolds. So I'm very excited to meet some new characters. Although, I slept for 2 months. Oh, whoops. I guess I'm the Darian. I'm worse than Darian. I would rather get Palutena early on. I'm probably gonna make a beeline for that. Should I interrupt? I'll interrupt. A dozen heads turn in your direction. The villagers recognize you, and their eyes widen with hope and reverence. What's this about? Yeah, I have no idea.
What's ours?
It's a small army from Raid Saris. They call themselves the Iron Flail.
Your dream of the mysterious army and the destruction of Cadnua. As the image fades, you see once more the vision of 100 eyes watching you and something just beyond.
Showed up a few weeks after you opened the battery. Demanded we give them the White Forge. They're led by a Dark Sentimer. Comes from an old Raid Saren family. Rumor has it the man's half mad with visions. Claims one drove him here to take the White Forge.
They're not the only bloodsuckers around here.
Our crew at the battery locked their doors and told the Iron Flail to go back to Raid Saris. Instead, they built a fort in the middle of the wood. So we sent a committee to reason with them. That was a week ago. We haven't seen our people since.
Well, that sucks.
I can only mean one thing.
Shrug? Should I shrug?
After what they did to our neighbors?
Only thing they know how to do is start wars!
Please, everyone! Whatever our differences, we've got to deal with the army at our gates. You've done a lot for Stalwart already. Many of us wouldn't even be here if it wasn't for you.
I love my name.
What I mean is, if anyone could deal with an army, it's you.
I guess I will help you, because
the
I would
Iron
like
Flail cleared a patch of forest
here.
North of Durgan's battery. Built a fort there. It'll be well guarded, so if you can get in without raising an alarm, you may have an easier time of it. The important thing is
right.
To deal with the commander.
If
you can get rid of him, the rest of the soldiers will scatter.
Should I tell this fucking loser Darian about my dream? I don't think so.
We've got our work cut out for us here. While you're out, stop by the battery. Wangra and her team are still repairing the heavy cannons. They've made a lot of progress elsewhere. Thought you might like to see how far it's come.
Cool. Let's stop talking forever, Darian. Is this new? Yeah, Darian's the last person who needs to know. Fucking Darian. Yeah, this is new. You know, I should probably be sneaking.
Hello? Hello?
If I can just... How do you rotate this, son of a bitch? Whatever. That's, yeah, that's unsurprising. Okay. Did I just summon skeletons? I didn't mean to summon skeletons. Accidentally charming a lot of shit lately. So I don't know who's gonna stay on my party for how long. Look, we've all been young. Who hasn't accidentally summoned a skeleton or two?
I shall be discreet.
Why are there fucking zombies hanging out in the woods? Vampire bats. Is this place haunted? Hell yeah, I'm gonna pick this mushroom. Aw, man! Okay. Okay. This blob is officially larger than the entire map now. Oh, I hope this doesn't make the game run out of memory. I should probably kill it. Why is this blob invisible? Who is this ghoul? Why are you just hanging out, man? Who summoned you? I didn't even know I could do that. I guess it's the giant slime monster from hell is probably a little more worrying than a friend who wants to help me and then go back to hell. Yeah, this also seems chill. Hey, friends! Just clearing the map.
Which is not very,
very calm. Quiet. Okay, now there seems like there's a little more going on. So I'm gonna flip this, kick this guy. That was incredibly effective, whatever the fuck just happened. It wasn't the poison cloud. Oh, I'm dead. Yeah, they did a lot of damage real quick to me. Well, if we sing long enough. Do it. Yeah, let's find some wounds a little bit there, bud. You just go to town. Yeah, our... No, he's not dead. Yes, he's dead. Yeah, this is... I mean, this is a very winnable fight, but I've really done my best to cock this up. Okay, I guess when I said winnable fight, I said I should just unpause it because I've already won the fight. Hey, hey, hey. Is everyone, like, good? Seems like it.
Nice and quiet.
Don't think we'll find much. Taug's people picked the place clean.
There's gotta be something left under all this snow.
Who are these jerks? Let's summon someone who's actually good at sneaking.
Ready, Watcher.
Sure. They're just punks.
Following your lead.
Lead the way.
Shit. I don't know how sound works in this game, but hopefully they don't hear this.
Tell me.
Well, my strategy seems to be just incredibly powerful because, oh fuck. I'm playing without a priest because I'm sick of his shit. And because I make a lot of mistakes because I've played this game before, so I have a lot of false confidence. To like keep them alive for some reason. Maybe I should have picked up quests before coming to the combat zone.
Sure thing.
Oh, buddy. Oh, I have bad news about your friends. Oh, shit. Just two guys left. Okay. I mean, that's what priests are for, right? Theoretically. Should I go in here? No. But there are berries.
Still don't see why we had to hurt the dogs.
Shut it about the blazing dogs!
Oops. You punched the dog. Ow. Just gonna sit here for a minute.
Slowly now.
I'm sorry, bears.
Sure.
Nothing will slip past me.
Death ring seems useful. I should use it sometime. Hello. You don't want to talk? Well then I guess I'll murder your priest first. Oh, he's my friend now. Oh. An enemy boy is right up my butt. What just happened? Oh, he jumped and turned. Was like right there. Okay. I didn't know they could jump into the air. Wait, I can do that? No. Oh, there sure seem like a lot of them. Yeah, let's actually. Who keeps making everyone my friend? Who? Who is dominating? I must have equipped something strange. Oh, yeah, I should just do this. Hey, everyone, get out of the way. Oh, well, or just stay in the way. Sweet. What is that? What is that? What is that? What is that? This game. Can't you sing something yet? Yes. weapon that dominates on crits. Okay, yes, thank you for having a better memory of the last time I streamed this than I do. It's genuinely very useful.
No, awesome. What?
I tried to make you my friend. It must be Palagia. Who else would... crit so often. Am I looking at the... Oh, spell chance dominate. Yeah, there we go. It's your old pal... Geared Havenis.
Will do.
Hey guys, you got any cool stuff I can steal off your corpses? Avalanche site, isolated pedestal, lake, can't really do anything. I guess let's go to the house. Oh, that's hilarious and also sad. But I can see how that would happen. Beg your pardon, my lord. Who's Kern? I guess we'll. Chances that she's alive? He's alive? What? This seems a bad scene. I'm not even gonna read it. Well, this sucks. Thanks for the money off your corpse. Let's go talk to this dwarf. Oh yeah, and I guess we should tell you people. Okay. Stop skating eventually. I wonder if anyone's gonna give me side quests that I've completed. I hope so.
Tumak. Leave the pig alone.
What was his name? Did I even get a quest? I guess it doesn't matter. Well, RIP Hattie. No one gives a shit about avenging you, just whoever they're really after. Do I really have to go all the way? Why am I supposed to talk? I didn't talk to anyone in town. You're right. I could have. Wait, what's going on here, though? I don't know, I was intrigued by this quest.
You want me to go back up there? After nearly losing my leg?
You still got it, don't
ya? I got this guy. I'm not gonna go to the fort yet. You're the one that cracked this jelly jar in the first place. What happened? Weird. Okay. Oh, thank God. I don't have to go all the way. The back of the Orlan's head is a patchwork of singed green-brown fur and dark, scar-rippled flesh. She notices you and jumps back a foot. One of her staring eyes is gold, and the other is hazel. She flicks her left ear, which is little more than a nub on her skull. At last, she relaxes.
Ha! Took you for one of them red Sarens! Then I saw you had all your teeth. Ha ha ha!
I'm hauling notes.
Hang on, gotta talk into my good ear. Now, what was... Say, ain't I seen you somewhere?
Your mother has?
No, I got it. You're the one who got us into this place. And you fired up the White Forge. Must have been a real sight up close. All that fire. Ugh. Oh, that's a real shame. Gotta take time to enjoy your work, you know?
What are you doing out here?
Oh, you know, clearing tunnels, blowing old barricades, just tidying up. But soon, I've gotta start testing the cannons. We held them off a few weeks ago, but they didn't run far. Set up a fort in the woods, and I hear they're working on some really fantastic siege weapons.
Must be something.
There sure is. Once we have the heavy cannons, that is. They're all the way up there.
Oh.
I sent a crew to the tower, but they came back complaining about Skuldrak and the other nasties. Nearly took Kolmar's leg off. Skuldrak did, I mean. That'd be a big help. I hate to let those beauties go to rust up there. And anything you find up there is yours. Batteries full of treasures, and the West Tower has hardly been explored. Head through the door and up
fun.
The stairs. That'll get you to that rampart. Yeah, Kulmar cleared the rubble before he took to getting himself conveniently injured. You should be able to work your way up to the cannons from there. Meantime, I'll check on our black powder stock.
Cool. That actually sounds like a lot of fun. And hopefully the next time I stream this is not several months from now, so I will actually remember these details and have a really good time doing some good old-fashioned dungeon exploring. Yeah, I should look at my calendar and see when I can do that again. Because I'm finishing up my game actually after the stream, so I don't want to stream too late because I would like to finish that up actually today for real and not think about it again. And that should free up some time in my schedule for sure. Let's talk to some people. Let's make some friends. Okay. Teal door. Like this is almost a teal door. Been keeping an eye on town here. You found anything near Long Watch for me? Mestla is dead. She went around killing people for Barath. Yeah, I remember that. Oh, I was carrying around her head. Gleaming Society's no more. Yeah, killed all those fuckers. New bounties. Dragon cultists. Well, I'm the dragon freer and protector, so obviously they must die. Okay. Cool. New things to murder.
You really did it. I mean, people have always come through here, talking about opening the battery, claiming the White Forge, all that. But I didn't think anyone would ever really manage it.
Oh, man. Halfrick was right all along. He was half right. What's this?
Oh, Havrick's the innkeeper over at the Grave's Rest. I may have been hiding in the inn when the fighting started. The raid didn't improve his disposition any.
Whoa, a whole case of Fenland liquor.
That's what Havrick said, actually. Look, I'm not proud of it, but I'm no warrior. What am I gonna do? Throw a net on them?
And now you're worried about some booze?
They say a single drop changes your life. You'll never want to have a drink of anything else. Probably that's all rubbish, but it's supposed to be very good. It's delusional is what it is. Hey, look, maybe, not that you have the face for it or anything, but maybe you could help me out.
Well, yeah, you seem like exactly the kind of person I want to help out.
Havrick keeps all the good stock in the inn cellar. Out of sight, you see. I mean, it's bound to be under lock and key, but I'm sure he wouldn't miss a single bottle. Not with everything that's going on. I'll pay you for it. I swear it. We'll split my wages. And the bottle, too, if you like. I just want to be able to say these lips have tasted the best the Ishmael Plains have to offer.
Yeah.
Nothing so kind. You try living here a few years and see how you turn out.
That's hilarious. Okay, that's the numbers that I'm liking. Lost 41, made 1100. For the last 2 years, a priest of... Here we go, wrapping it up. Priest of Andra and a crew of greedy sailors were all it took to row Devil of Carrick out to the spot where Alessa and Polani's ghosts were singing. Unfortunately, the chaos of the storm overturned the small boat. Devil of Carrick, the priest, and the sailors were all plunged deep into the grace of Jimena. Miraculously, most of them emerged in a great sea cave near Barda. Through the entrance of the cave was hidden from the... Though the entrance of the cave was hidden from the surface, the interior held wonders that had not been seen for generations. Sunken warships, trade vessels, and remnants of the unlucky travelers that had fallen victim to the grace in the pass. Devil of Carrick and the Ragtag group discovered a tribe of survivors that had persevered in the caves through cannibalism and limited raiding. Their extensive time in the cave had left them unintelligible and wild, as though some attacked the crew of the recently sunk boat. Devil of Carrick was able to scare the others off. Eventually, their group found their way to a pile of bones that contained the remains of Alessa and Polani. The Andrite priest buried the pair together and performed a service over the bodies. With that, the spirits retreated from the world and toward the beyond. I want to play that game. That sounds rad. Why is this villager barely injured? Because he's sticking his hands in the fire? You or Andred or both kneel on a stone floor, held between two men. The man pacing in front of you wears the armor of a crucible knight, and you feel Andred's half-hearted contempt for him as if it were your own. You feel Andred's triumph, too, when the knight comes just close enough for you to spit blood onto his boots. The memory slips away from you and find yourself back in your own shoes. Cool, that was fun. How about you? Wanna get your soul red? The whiff of salt and brine is in your nostrils before the room has even faded. The ground heaves beneath your feet, and a spray of ocean water roars over the railing as the ship heels under the wind. The ship shudders violently, and you are thrown against the railing. In that moment, you find your gaze pulled to the pitching surface of the dark sea, and see there an eye, broad as a shield, gazing back at you in turn. Fear and fascination sweeps through your mind, even as your senses recede and the memory fades.
Here you are. I was saving this up for a special occasion. And it doesn't get better than this. Genuine Fenland liquor. From over the mountains. All yours, my friend.
Hell yeah.
He did he? That shifty little crook never learns. I'll have it put away somewhere safe. Thank you for doing a decent thing. Here, for your honesty.
Yeah, I fucked those ogres up. Oh no, I failed the quest. Kern,
please piss off, Kern. I got enough problems.
Oh, this guy. Maybe you should have thought about that. Fucking asshole. Why am I gonna help this guy? Fuck. I'm pretty sure I should take him to Fantasy Prison. Minor cloak of protection. Wow, localized in several languages.
Does that interest you in a new blade?
I mean, yeah, I'll pretty much buy anything at this point. Give me armor. That's what I want. Armor, armor, armor. Give it to me now. That's not very good. Reflex? It's not great either. None of these are very good. Plus 3 resolve. Priests don't care. Fourteen's not very good. Wicked Briars? Okay, maybe that's... Okay, now you had one good thing? Okay, we need to raise that much money. Sophie! Come up here, babe. Come hang out. Yeah! Yeah! Yeah. Yeah. is this? I guess I don't need to know. Let's do it. This is how we raise the monies. Oh my god. Whoa, whoa, whoa. That's my clicking hand, baby. Oh my good lord, there's so much crap. Okay. Oh, nope, nope. Where's buyback? Sophie. Hi, baby. How you doing? Yeah, you're up from your big nap, huh? Yeah, don't want any of this. So, I can't help notice, but I'm still very short where I should be. Do not need to read a two-part morality play. Thank you, video game, for offering me the chance, but... Yeah, those are good for stuff. Definitely still any duplicates. Doing a terrible job, really, of getting anywhere close to where we need to be. Pretty sure I can do this because I remember it was very thorough about going through these. Oh, yeah, no, here we go. Anything blue can be sold. Bye, baby. Oh, yeah, now I'm making. No, wait, I can afford not making. Well, that's something real special. Oh, jeez, now I just need to find the... I guess that's not that bad. What's overseeing? 10%? That's not very good. Not very good. That's kind of good. Plus 2 is not very good, right? Okay, I think we can leave it there. I still don't really have any interest in going through and figuring anything out, but it's some good sales, I'm sure. Okay. Who do we want to talk to next, Sophie? Don't do that, baby. Don't look directly into the sun. We're in the middle of the ocean. Whose house? Tina? Great. Hey, Tina.
They gone? I heard the ogres outside, tearing down walls and murdering folk. Don't remember how things got this bad. But you're the new adventurer.
Oh, yes, I
am. Venengild's latest volunteer. A real spitfire, she told me. Bet you'd whip those layabouts at the mine into shape.
Oh, I've already murdered everyone in the mine.
Did you say something, dear?
Don't worry about that.
Me? I was the overseer at the mine, back when it was running. Got shut down decades ago when we couldn't sell or ship the stuff. But I still remember plenty about the mining business. And I got as many folk as I can digging out the entrance. Been praying to the salty wench that I don't forget too much before they finish the job.
Well, I hope I need you someday.
My hearing ain't what it was.
I said goodbye. Yeah, 2 months ago. She's been hiding in her house for a really long time. I do remember the ogre attack. That was a cool moment. Wow. She's really going for it. Is there anyone else I really need to talk to in town? I guess this dude. Hey, dude. Why'd you retire? Cool, peace. Nice catch up, old friend who I definitely remember. Sophie! She thinks she's looking for dinner. Or looking for mischief. Muta, do you want to come say hi? Looks like you're awake now.
I'm on the trail.
Oh, I'd never actually been in Tina's house before. That's hilarious. It's the first time I've ever met her.
The Red Serans have always been as cold as these mountains. They must feel right at home.
Okay. Well, that was a good fact-finding mission. I will definitely leave right away. Get the fuck away. Whoa. Well, I guess that's kind of the extent of where I can go. Or can I, like, get past if I watch the patrol path? Nope, he's just right there. Wait, I'm just gonna patrol past? Nope. Let's run away before that dwarf gets here.
Good thing I sold most of my jewelry.
Oh. You know, maybe this is just like a bad zone. I mean, what do you expect when you send a warlock and a... Oh, there is another person. Well, that was wild. Stop zapping me. Sophie! A bear! It's a bear, baby! Oh, it's more than one bear. Now I'm feeling bad about not changing the difficulty. Where are those steps coming from? This is hilarious. Can I zap him?
I?
No.
Okay. Eyes open.
Here, I brought you a scarf.
Oh, thanks, Mario.
Yeah, I'm not here to hurt anyone. Seems pretty reasonable.
Nice and quiet.
Found it.
Ooh. The thing I just sold. How do you sneak in, even? Doing a pretty bad job of that, as it is. Just sneaking in general. Wow, it is very large. It's a big fort. Oh, there are multiple gates. I'm sorry. Goodbye. Oh, he got a spell off. That's cute. The west gate, or because I was around the back, and it didn't seem like there was much there. I don't know if they're gonna parley with me after I slaughter every single patrol.
Rafa!
Who?
Ator! Don't go far!
Who? Were you talking to those dead people I murdered? Who were dead like you? I feel bad. Maybe I should up the difficulty.
Everyone's on edge in the camp. Almost glad to be out here.
And you? You don't think there's any truth in it?
Doesn't matter, really. There's nothing back home for me.
Come on. The commander will figure it out.
I don't even know who was talking right there. Oh, like that? Whoop! Palagina. I should have sent someone stealthy instead of just who would be fine, like, murdering everyone. I didn't think about that. Just now with the task at hand. Exactly. Should I reload? I mean... Is there a reason I shouldn't just murder everyone?
I'm sorry, I failed. Okay. Like, in a good way or a bad way? Like, are we good here?
Get a good shot.
Well, I guess I'll try not to kill everyone, but it's a little late now.
Yep.
I'm assuming he's in the big hut. Okay, we're gonna try and do this. I was gonna stop by now, but, should I just send, like, people
nothing
one at a time?
Nothing slipped
past me. Yeah, let me just...
Ready, Watcher. Got it.
Fucking hell. Okay, you guys... Uh-huh. Sneak past the murdered corpses.
Ready, Watcher.
That sounds like some creative problem solving. Yo, what the fuck? There's no way past. I guess I don't need to go up. Jesus, what? Where am I? No!
Ready.
Are you kidding me? Please tell me I saved right before doing that. I'm pretty sure I did. If not, this will be the end of the stream, and then we'll do this next time. Was I a big dumb idiot? No. That is kind of a shocker.
Sure thing.
Dozing guard.
I'm here.
I mean, these guys have just got to die. I'm sorry. Hello, skelly friends.
Ahead.
Ready, Watcher.
I'm here.
Okay, I'm gonna be very patient. Well, oh, it was shit. I almost wasn't patient.
Yes?
Oh, why is he going
up? I'm ready. Ah.
Just say the word.
Following your lead.
Tell me.
Ready, Watcher.
No! No! Fuck. This is fun video game. This is why I don't play stealth games. I just don't like load screens.
Lead the way. I'm ready. Ah.
Just say the word.
Yes?
How may I help?
Right.
How may I help?
You gotta be fucking kidding me.
Here.
You must get.
Nope, no, 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 nope, 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 no, no.
Gather your party before venturing forth.
I shall.
Please just give me. Fuck, 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 fuck. And if he comes all the way, then... Oh my god, wow, I didn't even see how close that came. Ah.
Yes?
Yeah?
This is doable, I guess.
Yes?
Uh-huh.
Yes?
Sweet yeah? Baby Jesus.
Not a problem.
Oh, the dog.
Just say the word.
Yes?
Oh my god, it's a little getting a little crowded up there, you guys.
Just say the word.
Following your lead.
Will do.
Please, please, please. Oh my god. Oh my god. What the fuck? Ah, and then the little piggy. comes running. Okay, I swear to God, if this says I've killed too many, I'm just going to throw this garbage game in the toilet forever. I'm not going to really, but that's how I'm going to feel. Also, if there are enemies in here, please listen, okay? God, I have to pee.
Enough! I've had my fill of... What's this? What? Who are you?
Okay, I really gotta pee. I'll be right back. Also, yeah, anxious cries rising from my goddamn brain.
Your scheming friends. Not a scrap of honor in the lot of you.
I'm not here to fight.
Just to talk, then? Like stalwart messengers? I've tired of their lies. I don't need yours adding to them. You want to talk? Set down your...
What? Sudden wave of memories floods your mind as clear as the day they were formed. You see Odema's campsite ravaged by the bivouac, I'm gonna call it. The halls of Cadnua. In the caverns beneath the keep, the stone around you bellows warnings in a dead language. Deeper still, a fanged maw parts like a wound in the world. The images wash over you, tracing lives and emotions from 100 different times and places. Not all are your own. Slowly, you become aware of the sensation of being watched. Reach out. Direct your senses, tracing the invasion to its source, Adaric. Conviction burns through him, bright as a brazier. For an instant, you share in his emotion, and a sourceless desperation rattles about your skull. Absent context, the fragments of memory, you see, are just images. A small house across a field of vibrant purple flowers, a sea of armored kith and flapping banners waiting on your command. There's an uncomfortable moment where you feel your twinned awareness turning in on itself, and then the connection is severed. Adaric looks startled, his face ashen. Yeah, it's another watcher.
That's not known to many. Not past these walls. Why have you come? Why now? You've come all this way to indulge your curiosity? Does everyone in the Deerwood boast of their afflictions? I wouldn't know. Perhaps we simply worsen each other's condition. What? What is it? Yes, we were in the middle of something, I believe. All this for them? Infiltrating my fort, skulking through
the camp. I did successfully skulk.
You could have turned around! If not for the delegates, all of this could have been avoided. Stalwart sent delegates to discuss terms of peace. I offered them the opportunity. I was generous. But Stalwart sent soothsayers, not diplomats, to frighten us with stories of the moon going dark, the earth shaking.
Well, yeah, she doesn't seem like a great delegate.
You're nothing more than a mercenary for a village of people unwilling to put their own lives on the line. With a village of fishermen, nothing, but they cling fiercely to the forge you gave them. Some of the men are here for gold and good steel, and I promised them their share, but I came for cannons. With the battery's cannons, we can hold the pass. Rayad Saris has suffered enough. Its sons and daughters have nothing. We cannot sit and wait for an attack from the Deerwood. There is an army coming. I've seen it. Pouring down from the mountain. It will crush Stalwart and come for Rayad Saris. The iron flail will be the wall that safeguards my homeland from the worst these fire worshippers can bring to bear.
Yeah, I don't think Deerwood's about to attack.
So I believed. Hoped, maybe. But that only means they're angry. They'll look for someone to blame, an enemy to fight. Let the fools at Stalwart mock me all they wish. I know what I saw. If they had seen the same, they'd understand. I warn you, if you think to taunt me, Watcher... My people are here because there's nothing left for them in Rayad Saris. But they would secure a better life for their children, if they can. I don't know who you think you're helping, Lord of Khat Nua, but you shouldn't have come here.
Yeah.
Why would they turn on their own? No. You're trying to trick me. This is all another distraction.
Yeah, that's good, Intellect 14, because we're now, like, you know, ingratiating ourselves.
If they were to come together, perhaps. If they built another of Mogren's devices.
I think that's probably maybe affecting an invisible score for this conversation or something.
The thunder followed me to the temple at Dawn's Reach, and the earth split beneath our feet. That you're soft-hearted, but it hasn't seemed to stop you. And that you have seen and done a great many things. Things I would not have otherwise believed. I led my people here because I believed we were on the right path. I bound my soul to this blade as proof of my surety.
The sword is no good to me now. Oh, you got a soulbound weapon? I got tons of those, bro.
It's yours. For as long as you can wield it.
Oh, okay. I guess not.
I'll call in our forces from the mountains. Please, give me time to explain. You should speak with Stalwart's messengers. Perhaps you'll get some answers out of them.
Cool. Sever the soul. Wait, does that mean I can undo soulbound things? Whoa, it looks like there's no one in this house anymore. Boop, 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 boop. I successfully did a thing. Diplomacy wins the day again. Good job, politics!
Found it.
Be cautious. Be constant.
Thank you for your help, Seawolf. I probably would have just murdered everyone without you. Yeah, I was gonna say. Who is this lady? Oh, shit! Four hit points. That's all you got? Yeah, okay, that's interesting. Good point. Terror of death or something leads me stumbling into another's memory, as whole and vivid as the first. You walk the dark halls of an abbey, dimly lit and quiet, your footsteps loud, a blur, and you are standing in a dimly lit room, facing a robed Aumawa. You recognize him as Kauto, the High Abbot. He beckons you forward. Examine my surroundings. You are in a wide, rounded chamber. The tiles beneath your feet are covered in strange, curling symbols. You recognize them as symbols of Andra, goddess of sea and memory. I think this is going to have to do with Maneha's quest. The memory blurs. When your sight is clear, you are standing in front of Kauto, and he is smiling gently down at you.
Drive the raid sails from these mountains, and you may yet spare many lives. The Tidebringer will be here in a week's time. Should you be delayed in your travels, report to him as you would to me. He will enter the reliquary and call off the army of Ionis in my stead. If you are caught, sister, you know what you must do. I will pray for your return, but we will take comfort in the knowledge that you have joined the rest of Andra's favor in her keeping.
Words jar you loose from the memory, fling you back into the moment of the woman's death and then into your own skin. But traces of her memory join yours. You know the path to the abbey to which she was to return, buried in the mountains to the north. The Eyeless? I think it's clear we haven't been the best judges of character recently. I'd better go ask them. Yep, that's smart. Shrug and walk away. What the fuck is going on? Did they get those cannons up and running? I didn't get them out of the dungeon. What is going on? What the fuck? What the fuck?
All the stop.
What the fuck? Oh man, that's a cool design. But I really gotta end the stream, like, honestly. This is so cool, but I gotta just gotta eat dinner. Oh, the wow. I wasn't paying attention, I guess. Wow, this is going poorly, huh? The fuck? I'm sorry, just punch the ground. Oh. Oh, that was worth a shot. Dead. Yes, everyone is dead. Okay, let me try this one more time. No, click. Wow. Okay, yeah. Now that I know how to take this seriously, I was just like, oh, new enemy type. Not like, oh, a boss fight. Hey. Just instantly kicked.
Yes.
Hey, please get up. Yeah, you know what? Maybe let's focus our fire a little bit. No, don't walk over wherever I just pointed. You know, I feel like fear is not really gonna do it. Let's just wait until we get a dragon.
Yes.
To be going a bit better. Oh well. Maybe I spoke too soon. Excuse me. Those elbows. They going flying. Let's just finish it off.
Just say the word.
Ready?
Hell yes. Music. Hey, I did it! As the last mage folk, falls, a tide of essence sweeps through the ether. It washes over you, and you find yourself in the memories of the Eyeless. The hulking creatures surround you, their sinew-wrapped skeletons clanking and screeching in the semi-darkness. Their bodies fill the air with the tang of metal and the musk of sweat. The cavern in which you stand, it looks like a cavern anyway, glows with the dim ambient light. Steel flashes as the Eyeless shift and stir. They stamp their feet and groan in rasping metallic voices. Their restless energy prickles at the back of your neck. And in the echoing rumble, you hear something familiar. It's the pounding noise from your dream, the harbinger of a terrible army. You begin to wonder how many Eyeless are crowded around you. You suspect there must be scores of them, maybe more. It's difficult to tell how far back the chamber goes, or where it is. Ahead, you see a glint of light. It might be an exit. Already, however, the vision is starting to fade. Investigate the glint of light. You cling to the wilting shreds of the vision. Oh shit, I accidentally clicked past it. The vision ends, returning you to the frozen and blood-churned mud of the fort. Well, I guess that's that. mega folk. Derek appears to have taken some blows. There is a purpling bruise along his temple, and his armor is dented in several places. He looks rather dazed.
Those things, they came from all sides. The delegate, no, you were right. The visions are true.
Oops.
You fought well, and I'm glad to see you've come through in one piece. Not many of my men were so lucky. I'll take what's left of our forces. Those that will follow me further up the mountain. We should be prepared if, when those monsters return.
Yeah, let's not work together.
If these visions really will come to pass,
just stay alive.
The worst is yet to come.
And I'll see you next game.
Where do I tell Kalu and the kids about that?
Can I see? Okay, yeah, what is it? The light up ahead is blinding. After the dark of the cave, you rush toward it. Even as it fades into a pale blur, you can't see where you are, but you hear a cold wind whistling through the gap and feel a spray of moisture sting your cheeks. I guess we should get there. From the eastern reach to Edir to Old Velia, people of all ages are manifesting a strange and distinctive mark somewhere on the inside of their left thigh. There appears to be no common link between the individuals, nor has any of them reported any ill effects from the mark. But few think that this is a herald of good things to come. Some well-traveled Valiants have claimed that the not-so-secret society has taken an interest in the marked people and may have something nefarious in mind for them. This sounds like a job for our old pal, Durant. So can I, like, go through here and, just steal stuff? No? Everyone's dead? Hell yeah. Alright, well, I'm gonna do that next time. Thank you for joining me. This has been a Pillar stream. There will be more in the hopefully not too distant future. Right? Yeah, let's do it, guys. Let's finish this game in 2019. And then let's not stream Pillars 2, so I actually have a chance of playing and finishing that game. Thanks, everybody. Goodbye. 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 Goodbye.